Hello and welcome, my dear students.
How are you all? I hope you are good. I hope you are enjoying all the lectures of all the subjects. My dear little gems of Standard 3rd, I welcome you once again in today's science lecture. So, my dear little gems, as you all know that our exams of SA1 is approaching and you will have to prepare well for all the subjects, as this time the papers are going to be for 40 marks unlike FA1 and FA2. As you know that papers of FA1 and FA2 were only of 20 marks. This time it is going to be 40 marks, so you really have to work hard, as teachers will ask the question, or they may ask the question which is twisted, which is complex, not easy one. So you will have to prepare yourself accordingly. So that is the reason why always in my science subject, after completing the explanation, I take the exercise. And after completing the exercise, I always take the question bank or the worksheet, which will cover the objectives or the subjectives which are not there in the textbook exercise. So I hope you all are following the lectures in the way for the preparation of SA1 exam. And I know I have the hope in all of my dear students that they are really going to fly with the good colors in SA1 as well. So let's get started with today's lecture. So we are going to continue with worksheet number 2. So as you know that in the previous lecture I have already told you that there are two worksheets for each lesson, for each chapter, there are two worksheets. For chapter number 7, first worksheet objective we have done. So in the second worksheet objective we will finish and then we will move on to the subjective part. So let us start our day with a wonderful thought given by Narjit Bhojani, one of your classmates. She has given the wonderful thought. Let us read and understand it. Success is vehicle which moves on the wheels called hard work. But the journey is impossible without fuel called self-confidence. Such a wonderful thought she has given us, which is depicting the importance of hard work and importance of self-confidence in one's life. Without hard work and self-confidence, you are not going to have the successful life. This is what this thought means in brief. So I hope you have understood the meaning of this thought, and I really appreciate Narjit Bhojani for her efforts, for taking out the time and finding the thoughts and sharing it with me and her friends. So I am really looking forward for all my dear students to send a wonderful thought. I repeat one more time, the students like Narjit Bhojani, Bhojani Sayyeda, Chattiwala Zohair, these all students are sending their work on the regular basis. So I am really looking forward for all the students. I am really excited to hold the list of the names and to call out each and every name who are sending me the work. So it's now your duty to set the work. So let's get started with today's lecture. So my dear students, please give the heading subject, today's date, then you have to write chapter 7, and then give the heading worksheet 2. And till then I will clear the board. Giving the heading on the new page of your rough notebook. So please give the heading like I have already instructed you. And here you will have to give the heading worksheet 2, as this is the second worksheet objectives we are going to solve today. So this worksheet is comparatively very small, but still it is very important because few questions if you practice again and again, only then will you be able to answer in the exam. That is the reason why am I just solving the worksheet, so that you will get the extra practice and during the time of exam you will be already prepared for it. So please give the heading, today's date, subject, chapter number and worksheet number 2. I will wait for few seconds for you to get ready for this lecture writing part. My dear students, you have to give the heading always, like I always instruct you in the lectures. I try to repeat it 2 or 3 times so that you can easily follow the instructions given. And I also request my respected all the parents of the students, please help the children in following the instructions given throughout the lecture. You will have to write the subject, date, chapter number and heading, worksheet number 2 in center, because you should know that this is second worksheet of chapter number 7. Though we are only solving the objectives for both the worksheet, later we are going to solve the question answers also. So please give the proper heading. And here the first thing we are going to solve is fill in the blanks, and the options are there in the fill in the blanks. So you will have to just select the correct word and fill it in the blank. So now I'm going to start the questions here, writing the questions here on the board. I hope that you are ready and you are also going to start with me. And answers we will write after the completion of the questions, as you know, as always we do in all the lectures. So my dear students, let us start writing the questions. And here question number 1 for worksheet number 2 is, fill in the blanks with the correct words. You need not have to write that, you can just write question number 1. In this question number 1, blanks are there, fill in the blanks, and the options are also there. You have to just read the blank, understand it and choose the correct word to fill in the blank, that's it. Again, I will write the options in the brackets. Now if you don't want to write the brackets, it's okay, but you will have to write the questions compulsorily. So let's get started. I hope that you have already started writing with me. So as you can see, my dear students, I have written 2 options in the brackets. Now I will repeat one more time. If you don't want to write the brackets, it's okay, but question you have to write, it is mandatory. So please start writing the question with me. So my dear students, at a time I am only going to write 4 questions. So you will also have to write only 4 questions. And then still 2 are remaining, as there are 6 questions. We will complete writing the answers of first 4 and then we will write another 2. So please write down all the 4 questions. I am going to wait for a few seconds.
As you can see that I have given the options in the brackets. And if you want you can write, if you don't want then the choice is yours. The brackets are optional, like I said. If you want to write you can, if you don't want, don't write it. But the questions you have to write and it is mandatory.
And again my dear students, let me repeat in the instruction which I have been repeating in all the lectures, that you have to leave one line. Please leave one line and please do write with the legible writing. So please complete first and so we shall write the answers for these. I hope my dear students you all are writing the questions properly. So now I suppose that you will have finished writing the questions. So now we are going to write the answers. Get ready. Okay, the first question is, roots help the dash stay fixed to the soil. Now with the help of root, dash can stay fixed in the soil. Is it fruit? No. Correct answer is plant. With the help of root, plants can stay fixed at one place in the soil where we grow them. Number 2, the dash has a weak stem. The dash has a weak stem. So the options are neem or grapevine. Neem or grapevine. Actually, while explaining you the chapter, I have already shown the picture of neem tree, how thick and how strong the stem of neem tree is. And you also might be knowing, you also might have seen neem tree around your house or somewhere in the garden area or somewhere, that how straight and upright is the neem tree. So here the grapevine is the correct answer, because they have asked about the weak stem. So grapevine is the correct answer. Grapevine. So now next question is, the dash is the part of a plant that grows below the ground. The dash is the part of the plant that grows below the ground, that is under the ground. So which part grows under the ground? Is it shoot? No. Shoot is the upper body which grows above the ground. So here root is the correct answer. I hope students you are writing the answers. Number 4, dash are known as the kitchen of the plant. So kitchen means here it indicates that which part of the plant cooks the food for the plant. Is it flower? No. The green leaves cook the food. So here the correct answer is leaves. Please write down the answer. I'll wait for few seconds and I hope that you will not take much time to write the answers.
So my dear students, just see the spelling of every answer, and here I have modified the spelling of grapevine. Grapevine, grapevine. So I hope that these answers were easy for you, especially for those who have watched my explanation video. For them the answers surely might be very easy to find. Now only 2 FB are left, number 5 and number 6.
So now my dear students, I am going to clear the board and I will write next 2 questions. And with number 5 and 6, these question number 1 FBs will be over. So please be ready to write question number 5 and 6 for FB. Number 5. Leaves give out a gas called dash, and the options are chlorophyll or oxygen. So leaves give out the gas called dash. In the brackets the options are written. Number 6, which is the last one, dash. So number 6 is dash grow into new plant. So here options are fruits or seeds. Please note down these 2 questions. These are the last 2 FBs.
So with these FBs our fill in the blanks for worksheet number 2 will be over, and then we will move on towards question number 2 of worksheet 2. I hope you will not take much time to just write these 2 questions.
Leaves give out a gas called dash, and number 6, dash grow into new plant. So my dear students, let us see the answers. So answer for number 5 is oxygen. As leaves give out the oxygen, we inhale the oxygen. So this is the answer. And for number 6, dash grow into a new plant, obviously seeds. So please write down the answer. And we shall move on to question number 2. So those who finish writing answer, please give the heading on the new page, question number 2.
So my dear students, question number 2 is, give one example for the following.
So I suppose that you have written this. Now please give the heading question number 2. Question number 2 is, give one example for the following. I hope that you have already given the heading. So let us start writing the questions. As you can see that I have already started writing the questions. Please start writing the questions. And here we are going to write the answers. So I will make the two parts here so that I will be able to write the questions properly. So there are 6 questions I have written. And only 6 questions are there. For all 6, you have to give one example. And we are going to write the answers here in the blank space. Please finish writing the questions first. I'll wait for a while.
Again, this is same like 2 example answer, 1 word answer. And here it is not necessary that whatever answer I will write will be the only answer. Any example you will have to write it down. It could be of your choice also. It's just that you will have to check your answers if you are writing your own examples.
Number 1 is plant with tap root. Number 2 is root we eat. Number 3 is plant with fibrous root. Number 4 is stem we eat. Number 5 is leaf we eat. And number 6 is seeds we eat. So here only one example you have to give for each. So my dear students, let us write the answers for all these questions. I hope that you all are ready now. Number 1, plant with tap root. So my dear students, let me just remind you, tap root is the root which has one main root and the other tiny roots are attached with the main root. So that is the tap root. So here the example I have taken is from a textbook itself, mustard. Mustard. Number 2 is root we eat. So here I have taken the example beetroot. Number 3, plant with fibrous root. Again, fibrous root has no main root. It is just a scattered pattern I have already shown you in the explanation video. So it is totally opposite of taproot. So here I have taken the example onion. Number 4 is stem VE. So I have written here the example ginger. Number 5, leaf VE. So I have written here coriander leaves. You can ask even your mother or grandmother to show you the coriander leaves they use in the cooking. Number 6, seeds VE. So here I have written corn, rice. Whichever example you like, you can write it down. So please write down these answers.
As you can see, my dear students, I have written the example of my choice. Now here this question says that you have to write one example for each. Not necessarily the examples I have written you will have to write the same. You can write the example of your choice. For example, the last question is seeds we eat. Now I have written corn. You can write rice or any of your choice. But you will have to just check your answer if you're writing it on your own. Either you can send it to me and you can ask me to check it, or you can check it on your own in your textbook or on the Google, anywhere you like. So the choice is yours. So with this, I today complete my lecture by these two questions of new worksheet. In the next lecture, my dear little champs, we will start with the subjective revision of worksheet number 1 of the same chapter, that is chapter number 7. So till then, just complete this much work and keep learning, keep preparing. Goodbye, take care.